Good evening. Christmas is children and family, cards and mince pies and mistletoe and holly. Christmas is also Santa Claus and reindeer and turkey and presents. Christmas is also angels and shepherds and wise men and a baby in a stable. And above all, Christmas is about love and a God that so loved the world that he gave us his only son. We celebrate Christmas in many different ways, but the Christmas spirit is one of love, of sharing and giving and wishing well to our fellow human beings. Tonight, we welcome you all to Carols by Candlelight to share together in the spirit of Christmas.
Thank you. evil candle by Siddhartha Gautama. There is not enough darkness in all the world to snuff out the light of one single candle. Thousands of candles can be lit from that single candle, and the life of that candle will not be shortened. The light from the candle is not decreased by being shared, just as happiness and love are not decreased by being shared. The brilliance from a thousand candles can, together, light up the world.
Full of grace, the Lord is with you. Do not fear, for God has looked kindly on you. You shall conceive and bear a son, and you shall name him Jesus. He will be great and shall rightly be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give the kingdom of David, his ancestor. He will rule over the people of Jacob forever, and his reign shall have no end.
Issued a decree for a census to be taken. Everyone had to be registered in his own town. So Joseph set out from Nazareth of Galilee to Bethlehem in Judea, the birthplace of King David, to be registered with Mary, his wife, who was with child. They were in Bethlehem when the time came for her to have the child, and she gave birth to a son. She wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in the manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
Still we see thee, Lord. Christmas Season by Father Daniel O'Leary. It is easy to be seduced by the Christmas season, but Christmas is not about passive peace. It causes us a restlessness, a disturbance to our complacency. It is astonishing that God stole into our world in the same shape, that of a baby, in which we all started out. The simplicity of it is almost too much for us, but extraordinary things happen in the most ordinary moments. A baby contains the mystery of the universe, consecrating all the day-to-day things that sustain us, while every mass holds and celebrates the divinity of a million galaxies. We are all wounded human beings, and Jesus came to tell us that it is possible to start over again. But the message of the Saviour is not the preserve of the privileged. It is a beacon of love for all those struggling in obscurity.
Oh, The Oxen by Thomas Hardy. Christmas Eve and 12 o'clock. Now they're all on their knees, an elder said, as we sat in a flock by the embers in hearthside ease. We pictured the meek, mild creatures where they dwelt in their strawy pen, nor did it occur to one of us there to doubt they were kneeling then. So fair a fancy few would weave in these years, yet I feel, if someone said on Christmas Eve, come, see the oxen kneel. In the lonely barton by yonder coombe, our childhood used to know, I should go with him in the gloom, hoping it might be so.
A reading from St. Luke. There were some shepherds in a field taking care of their flock by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone over them. They were terribly afraid, but the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I am here to give you good news, which will bring great joy to all people. Today, a Saviour has been born to you in David's town. He is Christ the Lord. Let this be a sign to you. You will find the baby wrapped in swaddling cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, the angel was surrounded by many more heavenly spirits, praising God and saying, "Glory to you, God, in the highest, and peace on earth to those whom God loves."
Divine dream that is happening in the land. but disorder in the blindness that blocks that dream and vision. It is costly grace. God became human so that humans could become divine. Christmas is about roots and wings. We hold within us the sublime summit, the infinite horizon to which we aspire. Yet our feet of clay are rooted in the heaviness of a fallen humanity. In this domain of our daily dreaming, the Holy Spirit establishes his own communion with us. This is how the gift is given, the sudden illumination, the opening of the heart to the risk of love.
A reading from St. Matthew. When Jesus was born in Bethlehem in Judea during the days of King Herod, wise men from the east arrived in Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the newborn King of the Jews? We saw the rising of his star in the east and have come to honor him." When Herod heard this, he was greatly disturbed. He immediately called a meeting of high-ranking priests and asked them where the Messiah was to be born. "In the town of Bethlehem in Judea," they told him, "for this is what the prophet wrote, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are by no means least upon the clans of Judah, for from you will become a leader, the one who is to shepherd my people Israel.' Then Herod secretly called the wise men and sent them to Bethlehem with the instruction, 'Go and get accurate information about the child. As soon as you have found him, report to me that I too may go and honor him.' After the meeting with the king, they set out. The star that they had seen in the east went ahead of them and stopped over the place where the child was. They went into the house, and when they saw the child with Mary, they knelt and worshipped him and offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. In a dream, they were warned not to go back to Herod, so they returned to their home country by another way."
As we stand around the crib, by Father Daniel O'Leary. As we stand around the crib, something stirs in us. We look at the baby who will soon enjoy and endure the delights and vicissitudes of being truly human, who will later be engulfed in a darkness from which a great light will shine. We look at the baby and stir to an echo of heaven in ourselves and to the paradox in the manger. To be God and to be human, to be beyond and to be within. The sleepy infant holds the fullness of divine love in its finite presence and infinite promise.
Night before Christmas, when all through the house not a creature was staring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutter and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave a luster of midday to objects below. When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer? With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned with a jerk and laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down on a thistle. But I heard him exclaim ere they drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night."
Thank you. A Christmas prayer. It was cold, and Mary and Joseph were fearful, but that did not stop the birth. They were poor and had no place fitting for their child, but that did not stop the birth. Today, we are still sometimes cold and fearful, certainly poor in many ways. We often feel we have no place and are unclear about what God wants of us. But these did not stop the birth of Jesus then, and nor will they now. Lord Jesus will be born in us today, like Mary and Joseph, who trusted in your grace. May we entrust that we have and are to you. Bless the gifts we bring. Hallow our thoughts and actions, that Christ may be glorified through them, that we may bring light to a world that is yet in darkness. We ask these things in his name. Amen.
We'd just like to thank Father Bernard for allowing us to use the church this evening. We'd like to thank Irene and her team for decorating the church so beautifully. We'd like to thank the readers who all volunteered and read very well. And we'd like to thank Karina and John for training us up for this event. And we'd like to thank all of you for coming out on this cold night. Thank you.